She's back. She's back. A week late, but she's back. Ignore, you know, my hair, it's gonna be crusty. But I didn't come back last week because I had a lot going on. It was Thanksgiving week. So we're here now, and we're here with another video. So today is not gonna be beauty related, no makeup, nothing. Today's gonna be a crochet with me. So I have this yarn here. I'm gonna crochet a bralette. It's gonna be a Christmas present, so we'll see how that goes. I've been trying to get into crocheting for a while. For this specific bralette, this is the thinnest I could go. This is a size 6, super bulky. The thinnest I can go, because I'm just learning how to crochet. This is my crochet bag. I'll put it in the link down below. It's a mess because I have all my yarn in here. I'm gonna use a video. This is not a tutorial. This is a crochet with me, so you're gonna be seeing me learn and stuff. I'm gonna follow Shyler Crochet's crochet bralette beginner friendly video. So we're gonna get started. I'm just gonna show the things that I have. I have this yarn right here. Like I said before, it recommends the 9mm crochet hook, but I'm gonna use a 6mm crochet hook just to make the stitches a little bit tighter. I have this Fenty bra for reference on the cup. My friend is a 34D, I'm a 38D, so the cup size is the same. So if you're gonna make a bralette for people, I'm just gonna use this as a reference, but what you would wanna do from what I've seen in videos is measure from your nipple to the base of your breast and then make a chain the length of that, of how many inches is from your nipple and the base of your breast. Like I said, this is not a tutorial, so I'm not really gonna show you exactly what to do. You're just learning with me. So I'm gonna start off from what I remember. So just keeping a tail, and then I'm gonna do 10. The second loop from the chain, you go into the second loop from the chain and you make a single crochet. Now I need the video, so we're gonna go ahead and play this video.
Single crochet in every single chain up to the end.
Okay, so I'm gonna continue to single crochet all the way up to the end. So this is gonna be super slow. This is gonna be a really long video to edit. Halfway there, okay. Go ahead, man. So this is what it should look like. Like this. Ignore my nails, they're crusty enough. Now let's see what she says. So in this last little loop, in this last little chain, you're gonna do 3 single crochets into there. So one. The second one that you do in the same chain, this one you're gonna mark it with the stitch marker. So the second one that you do, so this is the second one. And so this basically makes this little round shape like this, and then you build your bra cup around that. By the way, the reason this sounds like a tutorial is because if I explain it out loud, then it sticks in my head. So just ignore me, just listen to her.
You're going to start walking onto the back side of the chain.
Mm-hmm.
So go in each and every chain with
a single crochet.
One single crochet. Going to chain up one, so you always chain up one at the beginning of every row, turn your work and single crochet in this very first single crochet. Go into each and every single crochet, placing one single crochet until you reach the middle stitch.
Single crochet into every stitch until you get to that middle stitch where you'll put 3 single crochets into it. I'm in the middle stitch, so I'm gonna take out my stitch marker. One. There goes one. Two, and then the second one you put in the stitch marker. Two, and then three. All right. And now, I'm gonna work my way back down the other side in single crochets. This is what my work looks like so far. I think it looks all right. So I'm gonna come back when I'm done with this cup and then I'll see what I do from there. Yeah, 19, I understand Julie and the Phantom is a kid show. Okay, so I'm back and I finished the first cup. So this is it. I kind of measured it. I think it'll fit because I'm a D, so this is my first cup done. I left a really long tail because I don't know if I'm gonna need it. I'm gonna go ahead and do the second cup. I'm gonna take a little break because I'm getting a little hungry, so I'm gonna go ahead, grab something to eat, do the second cup. I'll be back when the second cup is done and we're gonna get started with the base. So I'm back. It is now 8 o'clock, 8:09 to be more specific, because I got distracted watching Disney movies. Here's my other cup. I have both of them now. They should be the same. They should be the same. Just like that. Here are both my cups. Now, we have to make the base of the bralette. So, I'm just gonna see what my sis has to say. So, she took her first one. And she put her hook through her last one, the last stitch. She put her hook through the last stitch. And then with this yarn from the other one, she's gonna pull it through. Pulled it through like that. Right there. And then she chained one. She said you could chain two if you want it more secure. And now they're attached. All right, so now I got this part done. So I chained up 15 right here. Chain 14 on the other side. So 15 is only through. Now we go back to the side. Hold on. So check the second chain. 1, 2, second chain from the hook. Single crochet. Goes one. Okay, so I made it to the other side. So basically, she chained one and then put a single crochet in the first one, and she's gonna just go all the way back and forth until it's thick enough on the sides. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that off camera because I know it's gonna take me a minute, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm back. It's like 10:40 something, and I finally freaking finished, and I went ahead and finished off camera, but I'm gonna just explain what I did. But this is what it looks like. She's cute. She's cute or whatever for my first time. What I did is I left off like up here doing these rows. And I did, let me see if I can count them. 17 or 18 rows is from here to here. Not counting this one. So this last row, I don't know if you can see it. It doesn't look the same as the other stitches. And basically what I did is I did a reverse single crochet stitch all the way around. So that's what I did just to finish off the bottom. So you can't see like the little braid texture. It's more of like, it looks more finished. This red thing, it was in the yarn. I think it was like blended into the yarn. So I don't know. And the straps are super easy. Because this yarn is thick yarn, I just went ahead and just chained 80, and on the 80th one I tied it off, so that was like the last one. So it's 79 technically. On the backs, I just picked two spots to weave the straps through to make it like an X on the back, or I crossed it in the back, and then on the end I just tied these little knots on the end so that when she wears it, she won't pull out the string. See? So, yeah, this is my first attempt at making a bralette, and I think it came out really good. Like I said, go watch that girl's video. This wasn't a tutorial or anything, so I know it's kind of like choppy and all over the place. It was just a crochet with me, learn with me. I'll make sure to post a better picture at the end. Not on, but because this is a Christmas gift, like I said. But of like this laid out better so you guys can see everything. I'm actually gonna make them matching scrunchies to go with this. So I might post a video on that. I know this video is probably all over the place, but it's just me trying to learn how to make this. But again, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you like that it's not just makeup. So yeah, if you like watching stuff like this. Let me know in the comments below if you want me to try anything else. So I'll see you guys in the next video.